Welcome everyone. This afternoon, we're going to learn how Excel can be used to determine the best price for a product or service. The best price is the one that maximizes our profits, not necessarily the price that sells the most units. Excel's Solver is a powerful tool that lets us construct several models that are useful in pricing. We're going to use it to determine the best price for a particular product, an HP inkjet printer. We're also going to use it to help answer the oft-asked question, why are printers so cheap, and ink cartridges so expensive? This is the dialog box used to set the three parts of an Excel Solver model. The objective cell sets the value we want to minimize, like manufacturing cost, or maximize, like profit margin. The changing variable cells contain the variables Solver can adjust to optimize the objective cell. We're going to let Solver adjust product prices. Constraints are restrictions we can place on how Solver changes the variable cells. For example, we might be selling a product at Walmart and set a constraint that doesn't allow a product price higher than target charges for similar products. Once we've set our target cell, variable cells, and constraints, Solver tries all of the reasonable solutions that fit our model. It decides on an optimal solution, the values for the variable cells that yield the best value for the target cell. So let's pretend we work for HP and we're selling inkjet printers. We want to build a demand curve for the printer, then use Solver to find the price we should charge that maximizes our profit margin. Let's say we charge $75 for the printer, and we can sell 5,000 of them at that price. Each printer costs us $59 to manufacture. The price elasticity for the printer is 2, and the demand curve is linear. What price should we be charging for each printer? We know the two points on our linear demand curve are demand equal to 5,000 units at price $75, and demand equal to 4,900 at a price of $75.75. Open Excel and enter our values for price and demand. Select the data cells and insert a scatter chart with only markers. Switch the row and column to fix the slope of the linear demand curve. Right-click either the data points and choose Add Trend Line. Select the linear trend line and check the option to display the equation of the line on the chart, then click the Close button. Since price is on the x-axis and demand is on the y-axis, we can substitute the values from the line's equation into our demand curve formula. This is the formula we're going to use as the basis for our model and Excel Solver. Enter the manufacturing cost for each printer. And let's give Excel a starting guess for the best price. We can use anything that seems even remotely reasonable, since we're going to let Solver come up with the correct value for us. Let's try an initial guess of $70. Next, we need to set up a cell that has the demand formula in it. Enter the formula in the cell, then accept it. Under that cell, let's set up a cell that has the profit formula in it. Recall that we're using a basic definition of profit, the price we charge for a printer, minus what it cost us to manufacture the printer, multiplied by the number of printers we can sell at that price, according to the demand curve. Enter the profit formula in the cell, then accept it. Now, we can use Solver to determine the price that maximizes our profits. Navigate to the Data tab on the ribbon, and choose Solver from the data group. We want to maximize the value in the cell containing the profit margin by changing the cell that contains the price we charge for each printer. Now, we need to choose the right solving method. We're going to accept the default GRG nonlinear option because the formulas that make up our model aren't linear. Think way back to your high school algebra classes, and you'll remember that the graph of a formula that contains multiplication, division, fractions, or exponents is a curve rather than a straight line. That's how we know to choose the GRG nonlinear option in this case. Click the Solve button, and Solver zips off to determine the correct answer. When it finishes, it'll display this results dialog and put the correct values in our worksheet. For our example, it found that by charging $86 per printer, we can maximize our profits, and those profits would be around $95,500. So go ahead and click OK to close the results dialog. So let's make our example a little more interesting. Some products, including our inkjet printer, have strong relationships with tie-in products. Some examples of complementary products are DVD players and DVDs, razors and blades, cell phones and car chargers, and flashlights and batteries. With inkjet printers, the strongest complementary product is replacement ink cartridges. If we include the profits from selling ink cartridges in our price calculations, the price that maximizes the profits for the printer itself is going to decrease. Let's assume that, on average, someone who buys our printer keeps it for 3 years and buys a replacement cartridge every 6 months. So we're going to sell about 6 replacement ink cartridges for every printer that we sell. To keep our example from getting too out of hand, let's also assume that HP's management has told us we have to sell the ink cartridges at a price of $34. At that price, we see a profit of $12 for each replacement cartridge. Let's go to a new tab in our Excel workbook and enter the data we need for this problem. We already have most of the information we need from our work optimizing the price of the printer itself. The cost to manufacture the printer is $59, and we're going to sell an average of 6 replacement ink cartridges for each printer we sell at a $12 profit per cartridge. Let's enter a guess for the profit maximizing price for a printer when we take the profits from the cartridges into account. Again, it's not important that the guess is that close to being correct. Excel just needs a place to start the solver calculations. Enter the formula for demand that we determined earlier and accept it. We need to set a cell to show the total profit from both printers and ink cartridges. From our earlier work, we already know that the formula to calculate the profit margin for printers is the price we charge for a printer minus the cost of manufacturing the printer, multiplied by the number of printers we can sell at that price. Let's add in the profits from selling the ink cartridges. That's the number of printers we sell times the number of ink cartridges we sell per printer times our profit per ink cartridge. Enter a formula in the total profit cell, then accept it. Navigate to the Data tab in the ribbon and choose the solver from the analysis group. Our model for the solver is the same as our previous example, but this time, our profit formula includes the profits from selling the replacement cartridges. We're going to maximize our profit by changing the price we charge per printer. Click the solve button, and again the solver zips off to do the hard work for us. This time around, we can maximize our profits by actually selling printers at a loss. Factoring in our profits from replacement ink cartridges, we make over 5 times more money at the end of the day by selling the printers for $9 less than it cost us to make them. We're substantially better off trying to get as many people as possible to buy our printer, even though we lose $9 on each printer we sell.